This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel is a daily morning broadsheet printed in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. It is the primary newspaper in Milwaukee, the largest newspaper in Wisconsin, and is distributed widely throughout the state. It is owned by the Gannett Company. Contents 1. History 11. Milwaukee Sentinel 111. Founding 112. Becoming a Whig newspaper 113. The King Years 114. The Civil War Years 115. Becoming a Republican organ 116. The Pfister Years 117. The Hearst Years 12. The Milwaukee Journal 13. 21st Century 2 Awards 3. Footnotes 4. Further reading. 5. External links. History Journal Communications. Building the Journal Sentinel was first printed on Sunday, April 2, 1995, following the consolidation of operations between the afternoon The Milwaukee Journal and the morning Milwaukee Sentinel, which had been owned by the same company, Journal Communications, for more than 30 years. The new Journal Sentinel then became a 7-day morning paper in early 2003. The Milwaukee Journal Sentinel began printing operations at its new printing facility in West Milwaukee in September 2006, the Journal Sentinel announced it had signed a 5-year agreement to print the national edition of USA Today for distribution in the northern and western suburbs of Chicago and the eastern half of Wisconsin. The legacies of both papers are acknowledged on the editorial pages today, with the names of the Sentinel's Solomon Juneau and the Journal's Lucius Neiman and Harry J. Grant listed below their respective newspapers' flags. The merged papers' volume and edition numbers follow those of the Journal Milwaukee Sentinel. Founding the Milwaukee Sentinel was founded in response to disparaging statements made about the East Side of Town by Byron Kilbourne's Westside partisan newspaper, the Milwaukee Advertiser, during the city's Bridge Wars, a period when the two sides of town fought for dominance. The founder of Milwaukee, Solomon Juneau, provided the starting funds for editor John O'Rourke, a former office assistant at the Advertiser, to start the paper. It was first published as a 4-page weekly on June 27, 1837. A deathly ill O'Rourke struggled to help the paper to find its feet before he died 6 months later of tuberculosis at the age of 24, becoming a Whig newspaper on Juneau's request. O'Rourke's associate, Harrison Reed, remained to take over the Sentinel's operations. He continued the struggle to keep the paper ahead of its debts, often printing pleas to his advertisers and subscribers to pay their bills any way they could. Meanwhile, the establishment of the Whig Party in the territory thrust the Sentinel into the hurly-burly of partisan politics. In 1840, Reed was assaulted by individuals whom the Sentinel charged were hirelings of Democratic Governor Henry Dodge. Later that year, the paper abandoned its independence and proclaimed itself a Whig paper with its endorsement of William Henry Harrison for president in 1840. In financial straits, Reed lost control of the paper in 1841 when Democrats foreclosed on the Sentinel's mortgage debt and took over its editorial page. Only after the Democrats' successful election of Dodge for Congress was Reed able to regain control of the paper the next year. He sold the Sentinel to Elisha Starr, an editor who had founded a new Whig paper in response to the Sentinel's Democratic lapse. Reed later became a carpetbag governor of Florida during Reconstruction. Starr guarded the Sentinel's position as the sole Whig organ in Milwaukee. Heavily in debt, he secured the partnership of David M. Keeler, who paid off the paper's creditors. Keeler took on partner John S. Fillmore, nephew of U.S. President Millard Fillmore, and succeeded in ousting Starr, who kept publishing his own version of the Sentinel. Keeler and Fillmore trumped his efforts by turning their Sentinel into a daily on December 9, 1844. While still publishing a weekly edition, the paper finally began to prosper and establish itself as a major political force in the nascent state of Wisconsin. Having accomplished his goal of establishing the first daily paper in the territory, Keeler retired 2 months later, but not before opening a public reading room of the nation's newspapers. The origin of Milwaukee's public library system. Fillmore employed a succession of editors, including Jason Downer, later a Wisconsin Supreme Court justice, and Increase A. Lapham, a Midwestern naturalist who later helped establish the National Weather Service. The King Years. After running through 6 editors in 8 years, Fillmore sought a more stable editorial foundation and went east to confer with Thurlow Weed, editor of the Albany Evening Journal and Powerful Whig political boss of New York Weed recommended his associate editor and protege, Rufus King. King was a native of New York City, a graduate of West Point, a brevet lieutenant, the son of the president of Columbia College and the grandson of U.S. Constitution signer Rufus King. In June 1845, King came to Milwaukee and became the Sentinel's editor. 3 months later, King was lionized by the community. It was his suggestion that made the Sentinel the first paper in the Midwest to employ newsboys to boost street sales, due largely to King's connections to the East. The quality of the Sentinel greatly improved. He declared the Sentinel an anti-slavery paper and also supported temperance legislation. King invested his own money in the paper, purchasing the first power press in the Midwest. 2 years later, the first telegraph message wired to Wisconsin was received in the Sentinel office. The paper provided thorough coverage of Wisconsin's Constitutional Convention, held in Madison in 1846, when the adopted Constitution fell short of Whig expectations. The Sentinel was instrumental in encouraging its rejection by territorial voters. On April 6, 1847, the Sentinel launched a German paper, Der Volksfreund, to bring the city's large population of German immigrants to the Whig cause. Gen King himself was a delegate to Wisconsin's Second Constitutional Convention. He was also appointed head of the Milwaukee Militia and sat on the University of Wisconsin's Board of Regents, as well as being the first superintendent of Milwaukee public schools. In the wake of the Panic of 1857, King sold the paper to T.D. Germain and H.H. Brightman, but remained editor, covering the state legislative sessions of 1859-1861 himself. The Civil War years after the enactment of the Fugitive Slave Act in 1850, King joined Wisconsin Freeman editor Sherman M. Booth in calling for its repeal, and in 1854 denounced the Kansas-Nebraska Act. The Sentinel provided extended coverage of runaway slave Joshua Glover's liberation from a Milwaukee jail on March 11, 1854, after the birth of the Republican Party in Ripon, Wisconsin. King helped promote and organize the state party at the founding convention held at the Madison Capitol on July 13. King's Sentinel supported William H. Seward for the Republican presidential nomination in 1860, but rallied around Abraham Lincoln when he emerged as the nominee. Circulation rose with the looming Civil War, and the paper expanded to a 9-column sheet with the start of 1861. In 1862, the Sentinel bought Booth's abolitionist newspaper, the Wisconsin Free Democrat, and published it for 2 months before folding and sending its subscribers the Weekly Sentinel. Soon after his inauguration, President Lincoln appointed Rufus King minister to the Papal States. As he prepared to sail to Europe, the Civil War broke out. He took a leave of absence and was appointed a brigadier general later. He helped form and lead the Union Army's Iron Brigade. The Sentinel prospered during the Civil War, sometimes printing 5 editions of the paper in a day. Much of the war news was copied from Chicago papers, but the Sentinel did dispatch a war correspondent for over half a year. The war also resulted in a shortage of skilled printers, so in 1863 the Sentinel began hiring and training female compositors to typeset the paper, albeit in another building away from the men. This resulted in members of the Milwaukee Typographical Union leaving their jobs, but the war had already depleted their ranks to such a degree that the union later temporarily disbanded. Frustrated by the lack of skilled help, editor C. Latham Scholes tried building a typesetting machine, but failed after becoming controller for the city a few years later. He invented the modern typewriter. After the war ended, circulation fell off and the number of editions was kept to a minimum, becoming a Republican organ. In 1870, sole proprietor Horace Brightman sold the Sentinel to Alexander M. Thompson and other former owners of the Janesville Gazette. Thompson had co-edited Booth's abolitionist Free Democrat before the war, and while editing the Gazette during the war he had entered politics as a Republican, rising to the position of State Assembly Speaker. Thompson played a key role in securing the legislature's choice of Matthew H. Carpenter as U.S. Senator running the Sentinel. Thompson changed the size of the paper twice while diminishing the paper's local focus in favor of telegraphed national news. He also began publishing a Sunday edition. A supporter of the liberal Republicans, who opposed President Ulysses S. Grant, Thompson was ousted from the paper after Carpenter's former law partner Newton S. Murphy bought the Sentinel in 1874 with other pro-Grant Republicans, including Carpenter, who had failed to be re-elected after Murphy loaned Carpenter $20,000 to also become a stakeholder in the paper. Carpenter hired A.C. Botkin as editor, formerly of the Chicago Times, to replace Thompson. The Sentinel was soon perceived as Carpenter's personal mouthpiece and organ of the State Republican Central Committee after committee chairman Elisha W. Keyes blocked Carpenter from becoming a delegate to the National Republican Convention in 1876. The paper began running fierce editorials denouncing Keyes. The Sentinel later endorsed Carpenter over Keyes as senator in the 1878 election. Disappointed in the paper's weak defense of unregulated corporations, a new group of stalwart Republicans purchased the old Democratic Milwaukee News in 1880 and resurrected it as the Republican and News. Horace Rubley, a former editor of the Wisconsin State Journal and who had been the chairman of the State Republican Party, was hired as editor-in-chief. Failing to put the Sentinel out of business, the Republicans bought the paper outright and issued it as the Republican Sentinel. The next year the word Republican was dropped, but the paper remained a major force in the state's Republican Party. This troubled managing editor Lucius W. Neiman, who had covered the state capitol for the Sentinel and had seen the control the powerful moneyed interests had over state government when a Democrat was elected to Congress from a die-hard Republican county. The Sentinel's editor refused to print the fact. This led Neiman to resign and join the fledgling Milwaukee Journal. The Journal first received acclaim when Neiman's coverage of a deadly hotel fire revealed it to be a fire trap, but the Sentinel defended the hotel's management, which included a Sentinel stockholder. The Milwaukee Journal became the paper's primary competition for the next 11 decades. Historian Frederick Jackson Turner was the Sentinel's Madison correspondent for a year, beginning in April 1884. While he finished his senior year at the University of Wisconsin, he covered various aspects of life in Madison, from campus news to the state legislature. He delivered the scoop that university regent and state political boss Elisha W. Keyes wished to remove university president John Bascom for political reasons, and it was Turner's reports that resulted in a backlash of support for the president. Bascom had earlier offered Turner a position teaching elocution at the university that he turned down in favor of working for the Sentinel for 9 more months. He left the paper after Republicans appointed him as the transcribing clerk to Wisconsin's state Senate before later going on to teach history in 1892-1893. The Sentinel moved temporarily from its home on Mason Street so that the old building could be torn down and a new, state-of-the-art structure could be erected in its place. The Pfister years. With the dawning of the progressive era during the 1890s, the Sentinel began to moderate its views, often echoing calls for political reform. After the Panic of 1893, a private utility monopoly run by stalwart Republican Party bosses Charles F. Pfister and Henry C. Payne, the Milwaukee Electric Railway and Light Company TMER. Duties, immersing himself in the paper's operations and directing political coverage. Owning the Sentinel expanded his conservative influence from the convention backrooms to the pages of the largest daily paper in Wisconsin. The Sentinel immediately opposed the newly elected Governor La Follette. During La Follette's successful re-election campaign in 1902, Pfister's political power was diminished after it had been revealed that he had secretly purchased the editorial pages of some 300 of the state's newspapers. The Sentinel continued to denounce La Follette for over 20 years, whether it be for his reforms or his stand against U.S. participation in World War I. In 1905, Pfister was indicted in a rendering company bribery scandal by Milwaukee District Attorney and future Wisconsin Governor Francis McGovern, but was acquitted for lack of testimony. Pfister sold the paper to the William Randolph Hearst's newspaper syndicate on June 1, 1924. The Hearst years. A majority stake was purchased by the Hearst Corporation in 1924. Operations of the Sentinel were joined to Hearst's papers, the Afternoon Wisconsin News and the Morning Milwaukee Telegram, the latter being merged with the Sentinel as the Milwaukee Sentinel. Arrangement: the Wisconsin News changed the call letters of WSOE to WISN on January 23, 1928. The station was sold to the Wisconsin News in November 1930. Hearst's associate Paul Block acquired Pfister's remaining stake of the Sentinel in 1929. The News closed in 1939, being consolidated with the Sentinel as a single morning paper in 1955. Hearst purchased television station WTVW and changed the call letters to WISN-TV. Hearst operated the Sentinel until 1962, when, following a long and costly strike, it abruptly announced the closing of the paper. Although Hearst claimed that the paper had lost money for years, television was directly affecting Hearst's evening papers in New York City and Chicago, forcing the company to drive income from the Sentinel to finance the other papers. The Journal Company, concerned about the loss of an important voice and facing questions about its own dominance of the Milwaukee media market, agreed to buy the Sentinel name, subscription lists, and any any goodwill associated with the name. The new Sentinel building at Plankinton in Michigan was torn down, the presses were shipped to Hearst San Francisco Papers, and Sentinel operations moved to Journal Square, with Hearst retaining WISN radio and television. WISN TV remains part of Hearst, while WISN radio is owned by iHeartMedia. Following the paper's sale to the Journal Company, the Sunday edition of the Sentinel was absorbed by the Journal, the Milwaukee Journal. The Journal was started in 1882, in competition with four other English-language, four German and two Polish-language dailies. Its first editor was Lucius Niemann, who wanted to steer the paper away from the political biases and yellow journalism common at the time. Niemann was an innovative and crusading editor, and under his watch the paper won numerous awards, including five Pulitzer Prizes. The Journal followed the Sentinel into broadcasting. The Journal purchased radio station WKAF in 1927, changing its call letters to WTMJ. It later launched an FM station, W9XAO, in 1940, it was later called W55M, WMFM, WTMJFM, WKTIFM, WLWKFM, and, now, WKTI-WTMJTV, Milwaukee's first television station, went on the air in 1947. Niemann's successor, Harry J. Grant, introduced an employee stock purchase plan in 1937 and, as a result, 98% of Journal stock was held by its employees. A small block of Journal stock was given to Harvard College, and funded the Niemann Fellowship Program for promising journalists competing with two raucous Hearst papers filled with gossip, features and comic strips. Harry Grant took a more sober approach to news presentation, emphasizing local news during his years as editor and publisher. The Journal received several Pulitzers and other awards from its peers. It was under Grant that the Journal gained a reputation as a leading voice of moderate Midwestern liberalism during the 1950s. The Journal was outspoken in its opposition to Wisconsin Senator Joseph McCarthy and his search for communist influence in government, which perhaps inflated the Journal's reputation for liberalism at its circulation peak in the early 1960s. The Journal sold about 400,000 copies daily and 600,000 on Sunday. The Journal was a Monday through Saturday afternoon broadsheet, containing its distinctive green sheet, also publishing Sunday mornings. Though circulation had declined from its peak, it still held a rare position for an afternoon paper, dominating its market up until 1995, when the Journal and Sentinel were consolidated. 21st Century. As of mid-2012, the Journal Sentinel had the 31st largest circulation among all major U.S. newspapers, with circulation of 207,000 for the daily edition and just under 338,000 for the Sunday edition on April 8, 2016. Decades of local ownership for both papers ended when Journal Media Group was acquired by the Gannett Company. Gannett owns most of the daily newspapers in the central and eastern parts of Wisconsin, 11 in all, including the Green Bay Press Gazette and Appleton. The Post Crescent. The Journal Sentinel has been integrated into the company's USA Today Network Wisconsin. The Journal Sentinel will now also collaborate with the Press Gazette for Packers coverage, and will adapt to Gannett standards, including newspaper layout, website and apps. In August 2016 awards. The Milwaukee Journal and the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel have received 8 Pulitzer Prizes. In 1919, the Milwaukee Journal won the award for public service because of its stand against Germany in World War I. In 1934, cartoonist Ross A. Lewis won for his cartoon on labor industry violence. In 1953, business desk reporter Austin C. Werwein won for international reporting with the series of stories Canada's New Century. In 1966, the series Pollution, The Spreading Menace garnered the award for public service. In 1977, Margot Houston became the first female staff member of the Milwaukee Journal to win a Pulitzer Prize. She won the award in the category of Best General Reporting for a series of articles on the elderly and the process of aging. In 2008, local government reporter David Umhofer was awarded the 2008 Pulitzer Prize for local reporting for his investigation of the Milwaukee County pension system. In 2010, reporter Raquel Rutledge was awarded the 2010 Pulitzer Prize for local reporting for her investigations and stories on abuses in a state-run child care system. In 2011, Mark Johnson, Kathleen Gallagher, Gary Porter, Lou Saldivar, and Allison Sherwood were awarded the Pulitzer Prize for explanatory reporting for their lucid examination of an Epic effort to use genetic technology to save a 4-year-old boy imperiled by a mysterious disease, told with words, graphics, videos and other images. Footnotes carat, Audit Bureau of Circulation's report ending March 31, 2008. Website ABC Newspaper Search 31 March 2008 Retrieved 31 March 2008. Carat E. Bruce Thompson Matthew Hale Carpenter, Webster of the West Madison, State Historical Society of Wisconsin, 1954, pp. 259-261 Carat Will C. Conrad, Kathleen F. Wilson and Dale Wilson The Milwaukee Journal Madison, University of Wisconsin Press, 1964, pp. 7-8 Carat Fulmer Mood Frederick Jackson Turner and the Milwaukee Sentinel 1884 Wisconsin Magazine of History, Volume 34, Number 1 Autumn 1950-21-27 Carat David P. Thelen The New Citizenship University of Missouri Press, 1972, pp. 278-280 Carat Herbert F. Margulies The Decline of the Progressive Movement in Wisconsin-Madison, State Historical Society of Wisconsin, 1968, p. 62 Carat This is based upon the fact that the initial lease was for 3 years, as well as that according to Frost, S.E., Jr., Ph.D., Education own stations, the history of broadcast licenses issued to educational institutions the University of Chicago Press, 1937, p. 213, in its license application of December 30, 1930 WISN stated that the newspaper was the owner carat top media outlets, January 2013, U.S. Daily Newspapers PDF Borellasluse January 2013 retrieved 31 July 2016. Today, April 11, 2016 Carat Murphy, Bruce 13 October 2015 How Gannett Will Shrink the Journal Sentinel Urban Milwaukee, com retrieved 8 May 2016. Will C. Conrad, Kathleen Wilson. MMA Junkie.com Sports Weekly. V.E. Gannett Company Regional Daily Newspapers in the United States Abilene Reporter News The Advocate Anderson Independent Mail Alamogordo Daily News Argus Leader The Arizona Republic Asbury Park Press Asheville Citizen Times Battle Creek Inquirer The Baxter Bulletin The Burlington Free Press Carlsbad Current Argus Chillicothe Gazette The Cincinnati Inquirer The Clarion Ledger Commercial Appeal Corpus Christi Caller Times Coshocton Tribune The Courier Journal Courier News Courier Post The Daily Advertiser The Daily Journal The Daily News Journal Daily Record The Daily Times Farmington The Daily Times Salisbury Daily World Deming Headlight Democrat and Chronicle The Des Moines Register The Desert Sun Detroit Free Press El Paso Times Evansville Courier The Ithaca Journal The Jackson Sun Journal News Herald The News Leader The News Journal The News Messenger The News Star Oshkosh Northwestern Pacific Daily News Palladium Item Pensacola News Journal Port Huron Times Herald The Post Crescent Poughkeepsie Journal Press The Salinas Californian San Angelo Standard Times The Sheboygan Press Silver City Sun News The Spectrum Springfield News Leader Star Gazette The Star Press Statesman Journal Stevens Point Journal Stewart News Telegraph Forum The Tennessean The Times Times Herald Times Record News Times Recorder The Town Talk Treasure Coast Newspapers Tulare Advance Register Ventura County Star Vero Beach Press Journal Visalia Times Delta Wausau Daily Herald Wisconsin Rapids Daily Tribune York Daily Record V.E. Newsquest Daily Newspapers in the United Kingdom The Argus, Brighton The Bolton News Telegraph. Echo, Basildon, Essex Evening Times Greenock Telegraph The Herald, Glasgow News Shopper, South East London. Milwaukee Journal 1919 Boston Post 1921 New York World 1922 Memphis Commercial Appeal 1923 New York World 1924 Complete List 1918-1925-1926-1950-1951-1975-1975-1976-2000-2001-2025 V.E. Pulitzer Prize for Public Service 1951-1975 Miami Herald and Brooklyn Eagle 1951 St. Louis Post-Dispatch 1952 Whiteville News Reporter 1953 Newsday 1954. Columbus Ledger and Sunday Ledger Inquirer 1955 Watsonville Register Pajaronian 1956 Chicago Daily News 1957 Arkansas Gazette 1958 Utica Observer Dispatch and Utica Daily Press 1959 Los Angeles Times 1960 Amarillo Globe Times 1961 Panama City News Herald 1962 Chicago Daily News 1963 St. Petersburg Times 1964 Hutchinson News 1965 Boston Globe 1966 Milwaukee Journal 1967 Riverside Press Enterprise 1968 Los Angeles Times 1969 Newsday 1970 Winston-Salem Journal 1971 The New York Times 1972 Washington Post 1973 Newsday 1974 Boston Globe 1975 Complete list 1918-1925-1926-1950-1951-1975-1976-2000-2001-2025